Hello, and welcome to Rooks Gaming. Today I'm doing a tutorial video on power leveling carpentry. Alright, so there are a few basic items you're going to need to start your power leveling. One of them is going to be a saw. For you newer gamers, this is going to be a primitive saw. And a knife. Also a primitive knife for your newer gamers to Life is Feudal. And a bonus item for your power leveling is going to be the carpenter's outfit. This is going to enable you to cut billets much faster. Handles require softwood billets. Don't confuse this and do all of your work with hardwood billets. You're just going to do a lot of work for absolutely nothing. Okay, once we have our saw equipped and our knife in our inventory, we are going to cut boards, or billets rather, out of softwood. And I do this extremely quickly because I am a pretty high level carpenter. And I am wearing the carpenter's outfit, which causes me to saw at probably double the speed. As you're cutting these billets, you'll know that it'll stack in your inventory, and my inventory can hold approximately 24 of these billets due to my willpower at this point. I've sacrificed some willpower to increase some other skills on my character that we're using. So once you have reached your maximum inventory space, the billets stop piling in your physical inventory and start dropping in a bag next to you. As we're going to look here, the billets are still being sawed, but they're not accumulating in my inventory. And the bag is at my feet. So we're going to access that bag. It's going to open. It should have opened. See, I'm standing next to it, and I already have it, so that's a little trick. Okay, so if I hit my tab button, the inventory for that bag doesn't show up. But if I look in the inventory, you're going to see that the capacity for that bag is 10,000. Alexa, continue music. Alright. So now that we have our billets already sawed out, I have activated a power hour. And that is through the crafting characters menu. Down here, as we see, I have 46 more minutes left on my power hour. The quality of your food is going to determine how quickly your skill rises. So I'm at a food quality of 2.6 with a hunger of 76 out of 100. So what we're going to do is we're going to eat some skill food, which is generally 4-ingredient food. If you don't have access to this, the best food you can get will suffice. And our food quality is out at 3.6. So that's going to enable us to get more bang for your buck out of the power hour. So now we're going to go to our inventory, and this little anvil and hammer is going to access our crafting menu. We're going to start with the handles, and we're going to mass produce those. This is the easiest way to level carpentry. Also, you're going to need handles to make... Well, maybe someone else in your group is able to use these handles to make tools for everyone else. So this is not something that carpenters use necessarily, but everyone else does, and well, you want to help your fellows out. All right, so we can control-click these handles from our inventory to the dropped bag. And as you see there, it went over. We're going to do the same thing when our softwood billet count goes down in our inventory. We're going to control click another stack of softwood billets so that we can continuously power hour without a break. This is kind of key because you want to get as much leveling done in your power hour as possible. So as you see here, I've cut a lot of billets out so that I can make the most out of my power hour without having to do manual labor that does not affect my carpentry skill. Sawing billets actually does affect carpentry, but it levels that skill a lot slower. So preparing a lot of billets before you go into leveling is your best bet. Oh no. Alright, maybe you didn't see that earlier. I'm gonna do another example of dragging and dropping, so control, clicking the handle. There you go. You see it now. That's gonna drag it into the inventory. My little icon is blocking that. Alright. So, now we have softwood billets at 15. And as you see here, I pre-stacked all of my billets at 20. Because that's just a nice round number that my inventory can definitely hold. The softwood handles are not as heavy as softwood billets, obviously. So you can hold a few of these in your inventory and let them stack up without running into any issues or encumbrance. I have a stack of 9 softwood billets here, and we'll do that as an example. See, I have 11 left in my inventory, but I can control click that softwood billet stack of 9, and it goes right into my inventory, which then increases my count in this crafting menu to 19. And we can continue leveling without any interruption. Alright, well, that is the basics of power leveling crafting softwood billets into handles for carpentry. This exact same method can be applied to bow crafting as well. So bow crafting uses hardwood billets. That's the only difference. I advise not using your best quality wood when you're grinding these at low levels to go out into the middle of the forest and cut down a bunch of softwood trees for handles, stacking them, sawing the billets, and then power leveling that way. Watch out for animals, wolves and bears especially. And if you're doing bow crafting and you want to level that, bow crafting is also a skill after the carpentry level and requires hardwood billets to do. So, those are the basics of power leveling carpentry. Thank you for joining us at Rooks Gaming, and we will have some more how-to videos for you again shortly.